Mom, Faith and I have been trying and we decided that we can't have Christmas this year.
Why not, sweetheart?
Because it makes us upset to know we get to have Christmas every year, but people in Hawaii don't.
Why wouldn't people in Hawaii get to have Christmas?
Because they don't have any snow.
You don't need snow to have Christmas. In fact, there was no snow where the baby Jesus was born.
Yeah, your mother's right. People celebrate Christmas all over the world in their own ways and their own traditions. Come sit down and we'll tell you about some. In Mexico, Christmas is celebrated from December the 12th to January the 6th.
From December 16th through Christmas Eve, children often perform the Posada processions or Posadas. Posada is Spanish for inn or lodging.
There are 9 Posadas. These celebrate the parts of Christmas story where Joseph and Mary look for somewhere to stay. For the Posadas, the outside of houses are decorated with evergreens, moss and paper lanterns.
In each Posada, children are given candles and a board with painted clay figures of Mary riding on a donkey and Joseph to process round the streets with. They call at the houses of friends and neighbours and sing a song at each home. The song they sing is about Joseph and Mary asking for a room, but the children are told that there is no room in the house and they must go away.
Just like the real Mary and Joseph in Bethlehem.
Exactly. Eventually the children are told there is no room and they are welcome inside, where they say prayers of thanks and they have a party with food, games and fireworks.
Sounds like fun.
It is. Each night a different household's the Posada party. At the final Posada on Christmas Eve, a manger and figures of shepherds are put onto the board. When the Posada house has been found, a baby Jesus is put into the manger and then families go to a midnight church service. After the church service, there are more fireworks to celebrate the start of Christmas. There is even a piñata filled with sweets or small gifts for the children.
Let us tell you about the Netherlands.
For most children in the Netherlands, the most important day during December is 5th December. That is when St. Nicholas brings them their presents.
St. Nicholas Day is on the 6th of December, but the Netherlands, the major celebrations are held on the 5th of December, St. Nicholas's Eve.
The name Santa Claus comes from the name Sinterklaas.
It all starts on the second Saturday of November when Sinterklaas travels to a city or town in the Netherlands.
Sinterklaas travels with a servant called Sooty Peeten, aka Sooty Peters. When they come ashore from the steamboat, all of the local church bells ring in celebration.
On the evening the Sinterklaas arrives in the Netherlands, children leave a shoe out by the fireplace or sometimes a windowsill and sing Sinterklaas songs. They hope that Sinterklaas will come during the night with some presents.
A shoe?
Yes. They also believe that if they leave some hay and carrots in their shoe for Sinterklaas's horse, they will be left some sweets or small presents. They are told that during the night, Sinterklaas rides on the roofs on his horse and that a Sooty Peters will then climb down the chimney or through a window and put the presents or sweets in their shoes.
In many families, the children are told that Sinterklaas and a Pete will make a weekly visit, so the children leave their shoe by the fireplace or window once a week until the main Sinterklaas party on 5th of December.
Just like we leave out our stockings for Santa on Christmas Eve.
I'm going to leave out a sack for Rudolph.
Just like that, well done. See, there are similarities and differences in traditions all over the world.
Mom, Dad, please tell us one more.
Yes, please.
Which country you choose?
I don't know, let me think. Sweden!
Good choice. Well, around Christmas time in Sweden, one of the biggest celebrations is St. Lucia's Day, or St. Lucy's Day, On December 13th, the celebrations come from stories that were told by monks who first brought Christianity to Sweden.
St. Lucia was a young Christian girl who was martyred and killed for her faith. The most common story told about St. Lucia is that she would secretly bring food to the persecuted Christians in Rome who lived in hiding in the catacombs under the city.
She would wear candles on her head so she had both her hands free to carry things. St. Lucy means light, so that is a very appropriate name.
December 13th was also the winter solstice, the shortest day of the year in the old Julian calendar, and a pagan festival of lights in Sweden was turned into St. Lucia's Day.
St. Lucia's Day is now celebrated by a girl dressing in a white dress with a red sash round her waist and a crown of candles on her head.
Real candles?
That doesn't sound very safe.
Haha, well, small children use electric candles, but from about 12 years old, real candles are often used.
So you see, some countries celebrate Christmas time differently to our traditions.
How amazing! I didn't know any of that.
Thanks, Mum. Thanks, Dad.
We've made a decision.
Christmas is back on!
Yeah. from Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town in Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man called Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. The angel said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled by this and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. You conceive and bear a son, and you call him Jesus."
The second reading from Luke. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to all men." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Thank you. pray for Pope Francis, our bishops, our priests and Father Gannon, that they will be guided by the light of Christ and their ministry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for the parishioners of St. Philomena's, especially for those who are sick or lonely this Christmas. We remember the work of the HCPT, spread in all carers who light up the lives of the sick and their families in our parishes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for teachers that we will inspire young people to live the gospel values of truth, integrity and love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are homeless this Christmas. We hope that those who work for the Wayside Club, Mary's Meals and other charities bring a ray of light, dignity and compassion to their lives. Lord, in our mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for the dead. We especially remember Miss Tate. May they continue to shine on us like stars from heaven and guide us in our journey of faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We have no gift to offer Him. Jesus Christ, our baby King. We will serve Him all our days in joyful songs of everlasting praise.
Treasures and presented them with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.